Hello and welcome. This is Carolyn Ann O'Reilly, the channel, with a message and meditation from Archangel Michael, titled Smile Anyway. Welcome, 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 my beautiful beings of light. Smile anyway. Not everyone is going to like what you do, say, or think. It is, however, part of your mission to learn and remember how to love yourselves. You are, after all, my beloveds, at different frequency levels and vibrational levels, depending upon the inner work that you have done for yourselves and where you are on your own evolutionary spiral. Remember, my beloveds, like vibration and frequency attracts like vibration and frequency. Being with others of like vibration and frequency feels better than those that are not within your own frequency vibrational ranges. Beautiful beings of grace, you didn't come here to be popular or to garner the most friends. My beloveds, you came here to do your own inner work and to bring your very own special puzzle piece to the world that no one else has. There is also, my beloveds, a master blueprint at work here, not simply individuals vying for each other's approval and acceptance. It's really simple when you think about it, my beautiful beings of love. You contracted prior to incarnating to have certain experiences or learn certain lessons, and that includes interacting with many different personalities and egos. You also came for a very specific purpose in which to aid humanity, even if that mission is only to hold the light within the darkness. For some, your mission is nothing more than to remember that you are the light. Most missions, my beloveds, are much easier than the general human is making them out to be. There are some missions, yes, that are quite complex and have many moving parts and pieces, but that's not the norm. Some keep scratching their heads, my beloveds, and asking themselves, what is my mission? What is my purpose? The truth is that most missions are based on something that you are very passionate about, and you came in with a desire, albeit a brief memory of that specific gift. That passion can be traced back into childhood for most, before you started buying into what everyone else thinks you should do or be. You have to realize that you as a physical human and collectively as a physical society have gone through a substantial amount of environmental programming from birth forward. What was that burning love and passion that you had as a child? Keep asking yourself the question. You came in with all of your own most perfect information, my beloveds. Start putting that question into the ethers and ask your angels and guides to help you pinpoint just what that passion was before it was put on the back burner and replaced by someone else's goal for your life. My beautiful beings of grace, yes, you heard correctly. Someone else's goals for your life. Because that, too, was part of your pre-incarnated contract. What happened to that dream that you could see yourself being when you were a youngster? That goal might have changed back and forth a bit, but you kept coming back to that one thing that simply was very important to you. Keep asking the question, my beautiful beings of grace, because the answer will pop back in there when you are supposed to have the information. Reminder that your inner guidance typically speaks through you with the very first thoughts that pop into your awareness. This is before you sit and start analyzing away what you just heard pop in there. Because you don't think it could possibly be true, right? Remember this simple exercise of listening to the first thoughts that pop into your awareness right after you have asked a question. That is the first step that will help you to begin hearing your own inner guidance and removing the doubt that you are connected to your own spiritual support staff and higher self, or higher wisdom, if you prefer calling it that. You came in with all of your own most perfect information. Third parties simply don't have access to this inner space to retrieve this for you, my beloveds. This requires your own inner work to understand your own internal inner communication system. And that inner communication system is unique for each individual. It is an inside job, my divine beings of grace. Allow this messenger to take you on a meditation journey. Sit in a chair or lie down. Whatever is your preference. It's time to be comfortable and undisturbed for a while as you journey within yourself through meditation. Close your eyes and take a few deep breaths in and out. And visualize with each in-breath that you are breathing in love and renewal. And with each out-breath, you are breathing out pain, fear, frustrations, and doubts. With the last out-breath, feel your body relaxing. Allow and give yourself permission to feel the calm, peace, and serenity of this place. This place is so safe. My beloveds, ask your ego self to perch on your left shoulder. Instruct your ego self that it is only to be an observer on this journey. It is not to participate. Through prayer to the Creator, please ask the Creator to share with you a translucent shield of light. Visualize it all around you, forming a bubble from head to toe, protecting you from all outside influences and giving you warmth, radiance, light, and power. Negatives will simply bounce harmlessly off of your protective shield of light. My beloveds, the Creator has responded to your prayer. Your protective bubble has been supplied. The energies for this bubble will continue to flow from the Creator, cycling back down through you again and back to the Creator in a continuous circular loop while you are in meditation. You are now divinely protected at this moment, and nothing can even communicate with you that is not for your highest good without your permission. Breathe in deeply, my beautiful beings of light, and sense the lighter, relaxed feelings of being divinely protected and guided into this meditation. Breathe in deeply, and know that you are breathing to the pulse of the Creator. Breathe in deeply, allowing, seeing, and sensing within your spiritual imagination, your guardian angels and invited spirit guides as they join you now. The angels take your spiritual etheric essence hands and guide you out of your physical body. The angels then direct you into your etheric spiritual heart chakra. An angel is staying with your physical essence until you return from your meditation journey. My beloveds, you are visualizing, seeing, feeling, and sensing this within your imagination. Your guardian angels and spirit guides and special invited guests are with you now within your spiritual heart chakra. Your angels and guides are helping you locate the golden door that says, "To my highest guidance within." In your imagination, you have located the golden door, and now you turn the etheric spiritual doorknob, opening the door as you cross over the threshold, knowing that you are on a spiritual growth adventure. You find yourself in a white marble corridor with the elevator doors open waiting for you. Today, your angels and guides are whisking you into the elevator. The beautiful golden light illumines as they press the 12th floor button. You feel yourself rising, rising, rising in the brilliant golden light on your way to the 12th floor. The gravity falls away, and by the time you reach the 12th floor, you're floating in brilliant golden peace and calm, a truly euphoric state. You simply float off of the elevator as your angels lead the way to your very own celestial etheric home. You find yourself surrounded by your own celestial spiritual essence family. This is where you reside at all times, even though it is called on the earth plane the life between lives or afterlife. Only a small portion of your celestial essence ever comes to be embodied in incarnated physical form, my beloveds. The rest of your celestial energies reside right there in this beautiful, peaceful, wonderful, place with your celestial family. In this place, you learn together, laugh together, and grow and evolve upward together. Some within the group may evolve at a slower rate than others, but this isn't the point for today's journey. Some of you may be able to recognize the energy signatures right away, my beloveds, of those within this family that you might be able to identify. Those are the ones that you are currently in the earth plane contracts with. Some of you may need some more help here, since you're not yet as awakened to share this recognition. Be patient with yourselves and repeat this journey as many times as you can to receive further insights and remembrance. Today, your angels are handing you a pair of very special glasses. Since your celestial family is in their original energy signature state and not pictured as humans that you might be able to recognize immediately, these glasses will help you understand the differences in frequencies and vibrations. You put on the glasses and take a moment or two to orient yourself to the celestial family energies. The love that you are sensing is indescribable in human language. You feel the bliss and peace of all that surrounds you and can begin now to connect with each essence one-on-one. The glasses place the earth plane incarnated faces on the essence that is partially in contract interactions with you on the earth plane within this incarnation. Those essences are those that are on the earth plane at this moment in the now, and they may appear a bit fainter than those that have all of their energies present in the afterlife. You find that you can now distinguish the difference. You see each one that is playing a part in your own current life experiences. These glasses also show you a frequency and vibrational range and gauge above each essence phase. The angels hand you a mirror so that you can read your own frequency vibrational levels before discerning the differences in others. This shows you a current compatibility range that feels loving and accepting, as well as helping you understand those that have chosen, because of their love for you, to play a part in your current life that might be in conflict with your own frequency settings. Notice, my beloveds, how difficult it is for those having to play lower vibrating beings in your life. Their love and devotion for you is so very different than the part that they now are playing in your current life play. You asked them to play these parts, my beautiful beings of grace. It was to be part of your scripted experience in learning. They accept it only because of their deep love for you. This is unconditional love, my beloveds. Now, venturing outside the door, you see several other celestial family essence groups living around your light family. You are all loving and accepting beings in your celestial states. There is no conflict here. There is no competition here. There is only unconditional love, learning, and growth here. Each family unit is growing and evolving within their own divine etheric plans. Each is progressing higher and higher towards the Creator. You see through your special glasses that some of the other characters in your current life play are those from other celestial family essence groups. You can see their frequencies and vibrational levels as well. The more you look around, the more members of your cast of characters waving at you. It takes hundreds and thousands and sometimes millions to play all of the parts that one of your lifetimes entails. Each of your lifetimes is a very large production. The further you look in paradise, the more waves you see. You can certainly understand now why there are some that you are more comfortable with and find pleasing and pleasurable being around, while others simply do not resonate with you at all. The angels ask you now if you have a better understanding of frequency and vibration. You nod your head yes. The angels let you know that for today, basic frequencies and vibration is all that is on the agenda to understand, and that now it's time to return. You go back in and give each of your own celestial family members a hug. They wish you a benevolent outcome and tell you they are always with you, even though you cannot physically see them on this side of the veil. You feel their unconditional love and deeper desire for your highest and best outcome. You follow your angels back into the elevator, and the angels touch the button to descend to your earth plane, the origination point within the white marble corridor. The elevator starts its descent, and you feel the gravity begin to take control as you near the earth plane level. You sense your body as it feels the heaviness that gravity brings to your experience. You feel a little sad, but understand that you scripted this adventure and must get on with the play. Now that you understand and remember at a deeper level that you are not this body, but a beautiful spiritual being of light. Your angels ask you now, do you understand the conflict at different levels? And you nod your head yes. You not only see your own conflict, but also the global conflict. And you're remembering that all 7 billion entities on the earth plane also have scripts and celestial spiritual families that they have chosen to interact with. All have lessons and experiences that they have chosen for themselves, along with the ones that are globally, as a unit, that are being addressed as well. Everyone is evolving, my essence. One essence at a time, according to whatever their scripted plan has been laid out. Your angels express to you how very well you've done, and hope you can hold on to that remembrance of what you observe to help you walk through the balance of your own life script and each of its milestones and stages until it's time to return to your spiritual family in your life between lives. The elevator door now opens as you find yourself standing back in the white marble corridor. You catch a glimpse of your glowing essence in the mirror and smile as you imagine your spiritual family standing behind you. Your angels lead you back across the threshold of the golden door within, back into your spiritual chakra, and then they assist the return of your spiritual essence back into physical form. Take a deep breath to help you reorient as you wiggle your fingers and your toes, and when you're ready, open your eyes. Go about your day, remembering that your inner higher wisdom and angelic support staff are always at your service, working with you to help you reach your highest, most appropriate potential. Listen for those first thoughts that pop into your awareness, and know without a shadow of a doubt that you are receiving daily spiritual guidance. Beloveds, you are blessed beyond words and loved beyond measure, more than any earth plane language can ever express. I am Archangel Michael, the Creator's messenger of love, joy, wisdom, light, peace, and grace. Until next time, this is Carolyn Ann O'Reilly wishing you rainbows of love and peace and joy in your life. Namaste. This has been an Archangel's Pen production.